The issue came to our attention as KMT because we were dealing with farmer groups who were growing horticulture for export, and their produce was coming back as rejects because of the high residue levels. So farmers were really undergoing huge losses in their enterprise. So we thought, instead of these farmers abandoning farming altogether, why can't we introduce safer alternatives that can guarantee income from those niche markets at the export level?
The use of chemicals is where the challenge is. Now what we are doing is bringing in biopesticides in the integrated pest management system, which now is very safe. There'll be no chemicals in the food. Then it will mean that we shall be able to meet that international export market requirements. Of those who produce for the market are the smallholder farmers. But biopesticides has been used in the commercial large-scale farmers. So what we are trying to do is we want to bring it down.
KMT's approach to this whole challenge of the residue levels was twofold. The first approach was to create farmer demand for the products. The farmers were not aware that there's an alternative to the harsh chemicals that they were using. So we did this by establishing demo plots where farmers came to learn practically on what biopesticides are all about. The second approach was to establish a retail network, because we want farmers to access these products on a commercial basis and on a regular basis. So we also trained agro dealers on how these products should be stocked, on the benefits of the product, so that when the farmer comes to the shop, he comes away with the full package. He has the product and he has the information.
We're initially targeting 5 counties in our pilot projects, and we looked for organized farmer groups, farmers who are actually doing agriculture for, you know, like as a business. These are farmers who have had challenges with maximum residue levels in their produce, and have had difficulties with getting the product to market. And then we train these farmers on our products, on biological control, just to get them up to speed on what we're trying to do and how to use these products.
Hii mandao inakuambia iko profitable. Ni rahisi kuitumia, haina madhara. Ukipanda chakula inaenda systemically kwa shamba, unavuna wakati mmoja, iko rahisi, muda wa kuvuna ni fupi. Malaki hii ndio hata singine inapunguza muda wa kukaa kwa shamba. Kama sinuru pisi inapunguza wiki tatu.
Ukipeleka hiyo mboga kwa market, hakuna mboga ingine inaweza kununuliwa isipokuwa hiyo, kwa maana inapendeza macho. Vile inapendeza macho, hata kukula ni vizuri, ni tamu.
Kuna mama wengine hii manda yao yako nayo na wajui, lakini mimi kama mkulima naona kuna kitu hapa. Kwa sababu nikipiga hiyo manda yao kama hii tunaita Lecatech, kesho nikienda kwa shamba, unaona hiyo mmea umegeuka mara moja kama umeweka fertilizer.
The beauty of biopesticides is that they can regenerate themselves. Like if it's a fungal pathogen, it'll keep on sporulating and producing more spores, and therefore controlling the particular pest or disease that you're trying to control. And for some of them, farmers can even be taught to be able to rear them.
Since we've done the pilot, those farmers have continued to use those products, and farmers around them have started using those products, and the message is spreading very, very quickly. I think the exciting chapter now is, with the support of Kenya Markets Trust, how can we take this concept forward and really kind of take this nationwide, so that we can truly guarantee that the entire horticultural supply chain is using safe biopesticides.
From 2003 until now 2016, that is when we're now seeing the first official launch of biological controls by a private sector company in Kenya.
With the emerging disease problems, there's need for continuous development of novel management strategies to enable quick response to growers, exporters, and consumers.
Our product range consists of 16 biological control agents, all found, sourced, developed, researched, and registered in Kenya. These can be categorized into five main product types: insect parasitoids, insect predators, insect killing nematodes, insect killing funguses, and soil health products.
We want to move it a scale up from the two studies, the pilots that we have done, and we believe now that they are successful. We want to take it nationwide.
The biggest challenge we have is on resistance. The farmers we have in my area really do not understand the active ingredients in the products that we are selling to them. So you will find every other day a farmer will buy the same active ingredient at different trade names. So at the end of the day, they will be spraying the same molecule. So what will happen is that their pest will develop resistance, and at the end they will just lose their crop.
For us as Kenya Market Trust, we look at our input activities from the production up to the markets, and therefore by working with them, by building their capacities, by conducting expos, this is where we pass the right information. And if the farmers embrace this, then they are going to get better value for the crop products that they produce.